A teenager has entered a plea in the juvenile court in connection with the beating death of Christopher Jones back in May. The 15-year-old entered an Alford plea to manslaughter. 11 News iTeam reporter David Collins live tonight in Annapolis with details on that story. David?
Well, Marianne, the plea triggered an emotional day in court, and the case also sparked interest in providing more activities to teens to keep them away from gangs. Jen Atkins struggles to replace her anger with peace through forgiveness. She says her prayers are interrupted by tears asking God why her son Christopher Jones had to die at the tender age of 14. As Christopher rode his bike home from a community pool, Trey Robinson and Javal George each punched him once in the face, accusing him of being disrespectful to one of their so-called gang members. The medical examiner ruled the death homicide by blunt force trauma to the head. It damaged a major artery supplying blood to the spine and the brain.
Honestly, I know that he killed my son, and I know that he played a big part in his death, but he's still a child, and I feel for him inside, and I really do hope that one day I can forgive him.
Jen still sleeps with her son's pillow to smell his scent. She can't bring herself to wash the clothes he last wore. Robinson entered an Alford plea. He's not admitting to the offense, but acknowledges prosecutors have enough evidence to convict him. The judge is expected to send him to an out-of-state juvenile facility until he's 21 years old.
I think the judge Wack summed it up well. The juvenile could not have foreseen the outcome of what he did, but when you do something of the nature, you have to accept the serious consequences that flow from it.
In court, Robinson stood facing Christopher's family, stating, "I'm sorry this happened. I never intended for it to be like this. I'm praying for your forgiveness. I'm sorry." Christopher's mom questions the sincerity of the apology.
It meant a little to me, but honestly, I didn't see that he wanted to do it.
Christopher's death prompted an interest in providing more activities for teenagers. A local church wants to sponsor a life station in Christopher's memory.
Similar to a community center, but it's much more involved.
Court testimony revealed Robinson associated with gangs since the fourth grade. 15 complaints at school this year alone include allegations of assault.
There's nothing more that we could have done as parents to protect our child. And it just goes to show you that this world has gone crazy.
The other teen, Javal George, charged as an adult in this case, wants to be tried in juvenile court. A hearing on that issue will be held next month. Reporting live from Circuit Court in Annapolis, David Collins, WBAL-TV 11 News.